Welcome back to the shop. In a recent video, I made this really cool looking copper sphere to see if I could get this huge magnet to float inside utilizing something called Lenz's law. Lenz's law is when a moving magnet generates an electric current in certain metals like copper, and then that current creates a magnetic field that pushes back against the magnet. I came up with the idea for the copper sphere when I noticed that this huge disc magnet seems to float inside a copper tube as it's rolled on its side. I was actually able to get this thing to float, but my setup was more of a proof of concept. That video was super popular, and you guys left a ton of comments with suggestions on how I could improve upon the setup and a bunch of different things to try, so that's what we're going to be doing in today's video. I got quite a few things for this project, but most importantly, I got a motor with a speed controller. This is actually a sewing machine motor, but it was really cheap and it should be really controllable. When I designed this copper sphere, I designed it with a bunch of holes in it so that we'd actually be able to see the magnet floating as it's spinning, but it turns out it's still kind of difficult to see through the copper, which is why I bought a stroboscope. This is just a strobe light that you can really finely adjust and match to the RPMs of something that you want to look at that's moving really fast. Right now I have the speed on this motor maxed out, and the stroboscope is set to a little over 13,000 flashes per minute. So let's see what happens when I turn this on. So now it looks like it's spinning at 60 RPM instead of 13,000. And I'm hoping this is gonna help us see through that copper sphere. I also got a slightly smaller magnet, which is probably about the number one thing you guys suggested that I try. All right, let's get this thing built. I've actually already designed and 3D printed a bunch of parts, but I'll walk you through all the important stuff as I go. In my last design, I used these press fit inserts to attach a spindle to the sphere, but any little bit of wobble just worked these things loose, so I had to redesign them. And what I came up with was basically the same thing, except these have a heat press insert that allows me to use a washer and a bolt to really lock them in place. And to hold everything together, I'm just using these 3D printed clips, which I used last time. They worked just fine. So now all of this is going to sit on a new stand, which is a lot stronger than the last one, and this one has bronze bearings. I'm using three of these because I'll be mounting a pulley right in between these two. Right now the motor's going way too fast. It's about 200 RPMs at its slowest, and I need to bring that way down to somewhere around 20 to start with. So that's a 10-to-1 reduction, and in order to do that, I had to print a few pulleys. Now all I have to do is build something really simple to keep this up and away from the motor so that anything magnetic in here doesn't interfere with any experiments that we're going to be doing. Now I need to make some belts, and I'm just using this green polyurethane round belt. I've actually never used this stuff before, but it's supposed to be really easy to work with because all you have to do is melt the ends together. Looks about right. Now all I have to do to join these together is heat up this knife, and I'll melt both sides and then just slide them up and together like that, and they should stick. And to get rid of this bulge, you just cut it away with a razor. There we go, that looks good. I think I'm gonna have to experiment around with different size belts, but we'll see if I got lucky the first time. Let's try it out. Ha! Yeah, it's working. All right, turn it up a little bit. So that's going 200 RPMs, and now this is going like 20. That's exactly what I wanted. So now this is at 1,000. Works perfect. Well, it's black now, so obviously I painted it. And I also added this knob, which allows me to adjust the speed really precisely, and it will stay right where I want it. All right, let's try this thing out. I'm gonna use the bigger magnet first. Before I put this in the copper sphere, I just wanted to show you this magnetic viewing film that I got. I actually got it as kind of an afterthought for this project, but it's ended up being extremely useful and allows you to just see the magnetic fields, and it's really neat with these extremely powerful magnets that I have. Okay, I have the magnet in there now. So the first thing I'm gonna do before I turn it on is I'm gonna use another magnet and I'm just gonna pull this magnet towards me like this. So now you can see it's kind of like an eyeball where I marked the poles. The pole is now coming this way and this way. And we can visualize that with this magnetic viewing film. So now I'll turn it on. Now you can see how the magnet is orientated in there. And as I increase the RPM, you'll see that the poles kind of settle, or the magnet settles to where it wants to be within the sphere. So you can see this line here. I'm not really sure what you'd call that. I'll call it the equator. It's going to settle down. It's going to be vertical once it's in a position that it likes. There we go. So it's happy right there. So now I'm going to increase the RPM. And now it's just barely touching the copper. It's almost completely floating in there. One problem that I ran into with this setup is that because this magnet is basically just floating here, there's enough magnetic components in this motor to actually pull it over towards the motor. So to counter that, I just put a clamp over here, and now there should be a somewhat even amount of pull that's helping to center it in the middle of the sphere. And the reason it's a problem for it to be over to one side slightly is because as it moves over to the side, the diameter of the interior of the sphere is smaller, so there's more of a tendency for it to rub. I realize it's really difficult to see the sphere, so let's try the stroboscope. And if you have any problems with flashing lights, you probably shouldn't watch this part. I hate to say it, but I really don't think that this is gonna work because the sphere just isn't rotating fast enough. It's just not spinning fast enough for this to really have any real effect. However, one of you left a comment and suggested that I paint it with a fluorescent paint, so I got a highlighter and coated it with that, and now using a black light, you can kind of see through the copper. So you can hear that it's not perfectly suspended in there. Sometimes it's better than others, and it's all about finding that sweet spot. But even if I do find a sweet spot, it's still not perfect. And I think the problem is because the sphere is not perfectly aligned with the spindle. It's moving up and down slightly, and I think the tolerance or the distance between the magnet and the copper sphere is very small. So any little bit of movement takes up the tolerance that I have here, and it's just bumping up against the copper a little bit. So that's my theory anyways. I could be wrong and there could be more things that I'm just not considering here, but let's try that smaller magnet and see what happens. Actually, before I do that, let's turn up the RPMs and see what happens. This is not looking like it's gonna work. Okay, so it's going crazy here. This is definitely not working. It's just, I think centripetal force is just forcing it over to one side. So in my last video, a lot of you were adamant that all I needed to do was use a smaller magnet. So we're gonna find out if that's true or not. It's getting close. Is that it? It settled down for a second, and now it's kind of just tumbling. Well, unfortunately, it doesn't seem like the smaller magnet made any difference at all. If anything, it's actually worse. One thing you guys suggested a lot in the comments is for me to change the orientation of this seam here. So we're gonna put the larger magnet in here and see if this makes any difference. It does actually seem to be behaving slightly different. If you look at this, it's not settling down as easily. This actually seems worse. Well, it turns out it's actually worse to have it like that, so that was pretty interesting. Let's see if I can use one of these magnets to kind of force it into the center. Whoa. That's pretty cool. It seems like it wants to. It's definitely making it do some crazy things. Let's try two magnets. This magnet doesn't know what to think. It's like, it has no idea what's happening to it. I have one more thing to show you, and that's this ferrofluid. It's a very finely divided ferrous material that is suspended in like a liquid, and then that black liquid is suspended in another clear liquid. So it allows you to visualize magnetic fields, and it's a lot of fun to play with. So let's put it in front of the magnet. How cool is that? So if you want to buy one of these, I'll leave an affiliate link in the description. They're really inexpensive. It's just an Amazon link. And you don't need a really powerful magnet to play with this stuff. That is so cool. Whoa. Oh. Look, I just slowed it way down, and it's hard to describe that. That's really cool looking. And I'll go really fast now. Here's another really big neodymium magnet. This stuff is just a ton of fun to play with. I think I could play with it all day. Well, that's gonna do it for this video. Unfortunately, I wasn't able to get it to float perfectly, but I am really happy with the results. If you enjoyed the video, then let me know what you think in the comments, and if you have any suggestions on how I can improve upon this, then let me know. I'm not sure I'm gonna revisit it, but who knows. Anyways, thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next one.